I am so excited for our guests that we are going to have on. We just heard Downtown Attraction. And for more information, you can go to dtaofficial.com. And I've known Jack a long time. He was actually one of the guests on the Enter the Shell show. Mm-hmm. So I'm very excited to catch up with him and see how awesome the band is doing. But before that, as always, we start off every experience with an experience. And as always, Max, who should go first?
You can go fast.
I can go fast. I can go fast and quick, which is everything against a turtle.
Right.
the experience that I've been going through lately is just getting back in routine. I know that sounds really weird because, like, 2017 came and I just felt I was not aligned, if that makes sense. And only basically within a week, I finally, like, started to realign everything. And I stopped going to the gym for a bit. Or I was going, but I wasn't going as much. And just there was a lot of things that got in the way of just me getting back into my normal routine of life, which I'm not saying isn't bad. And me and Max, we had this conversation earlier off the air that change is good.
Sometimes.
But yeah, sometimes. But
it can be good.
Yeah, but there was
it's
just
like a rebirthing.
I think there was just so many distractions that I was going through at the beginning of the year that I was finally able to just move those distractions and start getting back into my normal rhythm pattern of my life. So that's something that I've been experiencing.
Nice. I like it. That's a good experience.
Max, that's a good experience.
Yeah, no, it is.
I was like, making fun of you.
I went on Sunday up to Pepperdine. The lovely Pepperdine University in Malibu, California.
The boo.
It is one of the most beautiful campuses that I've ever been able to kind of go and hang out on the lawns, because that's what I like to do. I like to go to these big universities and just chill. And so I went out there and I was playing bocce ball.
Bocce ball.
There was nobody there. It was so cool. It was just, you know, just a few people, and you know, it's overlooking the ocean and mountains, and it's just incredibly beautiful. And I was with my friend David Russo, who is probably, you know, in the top 10 artist of all time.
Okay.
He's incredible. He was looking at my artwork and he said, you know, you should do this for a living. And I was stunned. I was like really, really stunned. Cause you know, as whenever you're doing anything, whether it be art or music or comedy, you never think that you're good enough to, you know, make any money at it. I don't know. Do you feel that way?
You know what it is for me? Whenever I do things, I know it's all about time, patience, and passion. Mm-hmm. So as long as I have those ingredients in there, you know, if I get paid, that's going to be great. If I don't, I'm still doing it for the passion of doing it. You know, and time.
I guess so. I never thought that I was that good, because my mom was an artist and, you know, never felt like I could be compared to her.
As always, we are the hardest, what is it? We're the hardest people to ourselves. We're the hardest
critics.
That's what I was looking for.
Yeah.
We're the hardest critics to ourselves. Yeah. And I think that's normal for everybody, you know, to feel that way.
Yeah, I think so. But, you know, what an honor for an artist of his caliber to say that I had any talent whatsoever.
Flattering.
It's just, it is insane. It's like, oof. Will I ever sell my stuff? Probably not.
How do you know?
I don't know. I don't know.
You
I'm
put
critical.
It. You,
I'm
you
critical.
Have to put it on the universe, man.
I know. And he's what he
if,
said.
If
he
it
said,
sells,
you
it
know.
Sells. And if it doesn't, hey, at least a bunch of people saw it.
And Michael Kennedy from the Kennedy Center asked if I could hang my stuff.
Get the
and
fuck
I was like,
out of here. Get
yeah, I don't. I just here. Don't have enough pieces to be a whole show.
I'll make more. Sure.
I just,
I'll make 10 more. How many do you need? Have a turtle piece up there. No,
it takes
no
a long time for me to do a piece because, you know, I do animals and it's, you know, it's very labor intensive.
I'm sure.
Yeah, I could.
Our guest, who we are super duper excited, Jack Cash with us.
In the house.
What's up, guys? How you doing?
You have to get closer to the mic, okay. Little soft spoken boy.
I think I save my energy.
Do you?
Everything going fine?
What's up?
Everything going cool?
Everything's starting to get a little better. It's been a rough year.
Why? What's going on that makes everything so rough?
Oh, love, loss, relapse, you know, fun stuff.
All those dirty rock and roll words.
You know, yeah.
Love.
The stuff that we write songs about.
Right. That's true. That's what makes good music. That's why you have to experience those things in order to...
Well, some people can just write good music and write happy songs, which is I'm a little envious of, but...
Yeah. I don't know. You've written some happy songs in your life. I can't name one.
Exactly, because there aren't any. It's like there's the Social Distortion live record.
Mm-hmm.
Right before, I think it's Cold Feelings, and Mike Ness is like, you guys want to hear a happy song? They're like, yeah. No. Then he's like, well, sorry, homie. We don't do no happy songs.
Do no happy like, here.
Yeah. I'm glad I looked up to you my whole life.
Nice.
But
so you've been going, what else have you been going through in the past few months?
I've been homeless the past couple months.
Really homeless?
Yeah. Well, not like literally homeless, like couch surfing.
Okay.
A couple nights were a little rough.
That sounds fun, though.
I mean, I've seen a lot of LA. I've been everywhere from Skid Row, North Hollywood, Compton. Don't wear a red helmet when you're riding your bike in Compton.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's, really? Is it really like that?
I got run off the road a couple times, and I'm just kind of figured maybe it was because I was wearing a bright red helmet at 4 a.m.
Wow.
Probably up to no good.
But you would think that's a safe thing to do is wear a red helmet.
But yeah, I wanted them to see me, but not in that neighborhood. Area.
You got to wear something neutral like yellow.
Or so
like,
blue. You have to wear blue?
No. That just yellow. That
no, well, so I started wearing my like silver helmet because I figured Raider colors should be acceptable across the board. So.
Smart.
Yeah. Well, who knows?
Yeah. But from what I hear, you're moving right now. You're in the process of moving?
Yeah, I just moved downtown in the fashion district, so I'm pretty stoked about that. My friend Dan, who's in a band called Dev Angel, great guy, so he's like, dude, just move in, I need a roommate. And I'm like, sweet, because I need to get off the street.
But it was no fault of your own that you didn't have a place.
Oh no, it's always my fault.
Is it? Oh, see, that's very honorable that you do that.
I mean, I point a lot of fingers until I say it's my fault, but it's typically my fault.
Yeah,
every time.
What made you want to do this lifestyle for a bit? Was it to do writing or was it?
I think, well, lots of reasons. No one reason in particular, but a lot of it was just some band stuff, some work stuff, some just my mental health is not the greatest most of the time. And I had like almost 7 years sober. And then one day I wasn't even really angry. I was just like, I'm just going to listen to Motorhead and get on my bike and just be reckless. Mm. And I lost a lot of friendships. I gained a lot of new friendships. And I got rid of a lot of friendships that weren't really there in the first place, you could say. But, I mean, I don't regret it. Because a lot of good music came out of it. And I think when you're down, you really find out like who's there to help you, because a lot of people that helped me or put me up really didn't have much at all. They just had a couch.
Right.
And they're like, hey, you were cool to me. Or even when I was like sober, like I wasn't like an AA Nazi. Not, I don't think actually.
Yeah, you were. You kind of were.
Okay. When you're on probation and there's people like doing rails of coke and it's your place and you don't want to get locked up for your joint suspension, then I was kind of a Nazi. But overall,
It's hard to.
I don't really care what people do. As long as you're not loud and obnoxious.
Yeah.
It's like, do whatever you want, dude.
But you're in a rock band, so it's difficult when not everybody in your band is sober and you're trying to lean a clean, healthy life.
Yeah, but my. like, I use because I want to use. I don't use because, like, oh, I don't feel a part of, like, I want to have a drink. I'm just like, I don't really care at the moment. Last year, I just didn't care. And I was like, fuck it.
Well, I'm going to jump off the wagon. This year is going to be a better year, and you're going to care more.
I would like to care more, yeah.
Very right? cool. Yeah. I mean, we you know what? I went through a time in my life where I gave up drinking for 40 days. And I know it's a little bit more different from, you know, than
yeah, we can tell that right
life.
Now because there's a glass of wine in front
it's
of us.
It's wine time on yeah. the Enter the Shelf
show. It really is. Well, it's always wine time for Turtle.
I got some fruit punch,
time.
So I was stoked on that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got it. And that
fruit
was,
punch and yeah. burnt pizza.
And those 40 days were like really, really tough because I just noticed that in my life, not that it revolved around drinking, but alcohol was really involved everywhere that I went. And I was just like, holy shit, dude, there's a lot of alcohol everywhere I go. And so afterwards, though, when I was like, okay, 4 days are over, you know, I came through. And then I was just like, man, dude, should I continue this? Because I was like, maybe I could do this for like a year. But then I was just, I don't know what happened. I was just like, let me just slip back in and, you know.
I prefer when you are drinking rather than getting high.
I think, well, like, I mean, for me personally, it's just, it's a personal thing. Like, mm-hmm. I can still go out and maybe have a drink or two and then be done. But in the back of my mind, it's kind of like, if I could be with Cindy Crawford, why am I fucking with these dumb chicks on, like, reality TV? Why don't I just go out with Cindy Crawford if she says it's cool? Mm-hmm. So... I mean,
are you
that's
going
how
to
I feel.
Girlfriend right now? I'm like, oh, are you going?
No.
To... do you have a girlfriend right now?
Yes, I do.
Awesome. And how are things going with that?
Things are good. I mean, I definitely have a lot to repair because I totally went off the rails. But actually, I'm probably getting in trouble because I'm doing the show right now. But I'll make up for it when I leave and pick up some Valentine's stuff.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It's Valentine's
yes,
Day.
Yes, it is yes. Valentine's Day. And you don't know that because it's the day after.
Yeah,
I
it's
know.
Like the week after. Yeah. No worries.
Oh, yeah, I forgot. That's,
yeah.
It's cool. No worries.
You're in a level. We're in level 3. What's that?
Yeah, level 3.
Joseph Gordon-Levitt movie. He's like, we're in level 3. I'm like, that's awesome.
Yeah. Yeah. So how was your Valentine's Day?
Oh, it was great.
It was great.
My girlfriend kissed me a billion times.
Yeah.
It's totally saved the day.
Yeah, your blow-up girl.
Yeah, my blow-up
girl. Well, the dog usually saves the day. My dog, Logan, if anything's going on, I'm just like, go see your mom. Go cuddle. Look cute. All right, cool.
Yeah, that does it. It does it.
Yeah.
Brian Crow is cuddling with Arrow. He was cuddling with Arrow.
He now just made Arrow disappear.
Right? Immediately, as soon as... Is that a super secret guest?
Yes. It's called Real Life Pizza.
Oh, it's the Real Life Pizza.
Oh, this is the real pizza.
Yeah.
Because I was going to say, Craft Services, somebody dropped the ball.
Yeah. Yeah,
I don't
it was
know
Turtle.
What happened.
Dude, this look, I'm going to show these people the pizza that came.
Yeah, no, it was really bad.
This is what we got.
I'm glad I don't eat pizza.
The camera's not doing it justice. Like,
so
like the dog had trouble downing one of those slices.
Yeah.
This thing was like 100% burnt.
Yeah.
And just like unreal. And so we actually called and said, hey, like this pizza's unreal.
Yeah. It's unreal.
We can't
this
believe
is
it.
Unacceptable.
So, yeah. And so they brought us a new pizza. Yeah. We'll let Brian.
How is it?
How is it look? Did you look at it to see if it was? Maybe that's just how they make their pizza. Does it look normal?
It's an apple pie.
It's an apple pie. Okay.
Actually, it looks normal.
It looks normal.
All right.
All right.
So I mean, I still ate 3 pieces because I was hungry, but.
Yeah, see?
It,
you know.
It's tough. Like, as I'm eating, I'm like.
Yeah, you can lose a tooth on that.
You really can. Yeah. That's not what, I mean, I don't know. I'm no pizza connoisseur, but.
Danny's the pizza connoisseur, and she ordered it.
Yeah.
And, yeah. But she didn't eat pizza today, so she failed.
Yeah, she like sabotaged everyone's diet. Yeah. She's like, oh, have fun, guys.
Yeah, she runs to her room with a, you know, a foot-long sandwich.
Yeah, she got a meatball sandwich.
I did not say that.
Just you be quiet over there.
Right now, Jack is eating the real pizza.
Mm-hmm. Now I know why Danny ordered the pizza.
Yeah.
That's actually real pizza, not this cardboard thing that we were.
It's good. They redeem mm-hmm. themselves.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Good.
Vitello's on Ventura.
Now, the first song that we played earlier was Play Along, and I was just informed. I have no idea. You have a solo project.
Yeah, it's kind of been like something I've been working on when I was using. My friend Nikita was like, hey, I've got like a studio. If you want, I think you should just write about everything. And, you know, before we were on a label for a couple years and we couldn't release music. That was like another reason why I was kind of just frustrated with stuff, because I'm like, I'm an artist and I can't fucking release anything. Yeah. And you can only post so many photos on Instagram. Where it's like, okay, but where's the music? Like, are you a band, or you guys just like look cool with tattoos? You know, it's like, no, we have stuff. So then we go into studio, and I demoed everything, and Play Along just kind of came up. I was listening to a lot of like Deftones and Sisters of Mercy and like The Cure and stuff, and I was like, you know, we don't have a drummer, so I guess let's try to do something sort of industrial. And I had this little like. Like these, like the first three notes in the song, and then just that little drum beat, the doo-doo, ta, ta, and just kind of built it from there. And like, I played. It was also fun to write a song outside of the band and just be able to like, okay, I'm gonna write a song and not have like, and I love my band, but we're all very opinionated. And it's like, all right, you want to write a punk song, you want to write a metal song, you want to write a ballad, and I'm like. Those are like three different songs and we're trying to work on one song. So it was nice to just not really have any opinions and just be like, okay, this is what I'm hearing. Let me just put it down. Because when I write, I'm like, all right, this is how I hear the drums. This is how I hear the bass. And I'm just like, I'm just one of those annoying singers that I'm not the greatest at playing everything, but I'm like, can you do this? And then can you do that? And I'm just like kind of annoying everybody because I just want to hear it and right. See if it works. And if it doesn't, then I'm like, okay, I fucked up, but.
You mentioned that you don't have a drummer. You had two different drummers in Downtown Attraction, yeah?
We've had, I think, three or four.
He's like, actually 10.
Right? They blow up.
Well, the thing, it's hard for Downtown to keep a drummer because all the good drummers are usually on tour, mm-hmm. and we don't really have the funds to keep them around.
Yeah.
But, so currently we don't have a drummer. But we're working with this girl, Tasha. I think she's going to be playing with us on March 10th at the Viper Room. So I'm pretty excited. I'm really excited because she's like, she hits hard and she has a really good touch on the drums that we've never really had as a band, because usually like when people go to our shows, I think they just kind of expect us to be just loud, fast, rock and roll and like, you know, craziness, but like with some of the newer songs, it's like we really needed someone to like be able to have dynamics and not just beat the shit out of the drums.
Yeah.
Which is nice.
Yeah. It's a good thing.
You know, what,
you know, flavorful drummer.
Well, what I'm always curious about, and maybe you could take me through this, Jack, is I was really paying attention to when you did get signed, because a lot of people think, oh my God, that's all they want. I know a few bands are like, oh, all we want to do is just get signed. You actually went through that. And it's the same thing that I hear all the time, where it's the people, they want it, they get it, and then they're like, why did I ever do that?
I don't regret doing it. I regret the time that it took.
Okay.
I don't want to go into logistics of right. why it failed. But,
lack of you know, manager. Like,
huh? There's a lack of a lot of things, but
but that's good. Like, people
but if I'm gonna be
this,
like,
you know?
I mean, from my opinion, yeah. I feel like, you know, everyone like, oh, bands hate the label, the label's just greedy or whatever. And in general, like, everyone's greedy. Like, I know as an artist, like, right. I understand that maybe I'm getting 20% because 80% is going to all this other shit.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So I'm not one of those like artsy dudes just like, well, I should get 100% of everything because I wrote the song. It's like, yeah, well, this takes money. Fucking gas alone takes money to go on tour.
Right.
I think I'm only really angry with the fact that everyone's fucking greedy. It's like, okay, I wrote the song. Cool. I want to fucking work, dude. Yeah. So I think from here on out, like, I just want to work with whoever wants to work. And I think that's why Play Along came together so fast, because literally it was just a drum beat a month ago. And now I got, let me make sure I get everyone's name right. So Rob Short engineered it. My friend Nikita, sorry Nikita, I can't pronounce your last name because he's Russian. But Nikita produced it, and who's the other guy? I'm sorry. See, the pizza's so good, it's so greasy that I can't even get into my phone to look up the people's name.
That's how you know it's a good pizza. It's all about that grease. And I see that you fold.
Tuesday, we're here to give the backyard its blowjob.
Yeah, on a Tuesday.
Hey, look, they only come once a month, so don't stop them.
They only come once a month, Max?
Yeah, they do.
So, okay, scheduling and craft services is now.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Hey, you had two pizzas.
I did have two pizzas. Oh, and Jesse Shapiro was the assistant engineer. And it's like, I guess what I'm getting is, like, I want to work with people that want to get to work and are not just, like, the typical, oh, like, let's go get lunch, let's talk about it. No, like, let's fucking do it, dude. Like, shit or get off the pot, man.
Yeah.
And that's the majority of L.A., at least that I've met,
yeah,
where it's, like, everyone wants to talk, go to the party. It's, like, no, I don't want to be the dude at the party. I can party and fucking record shit, but...
You know, the thing that really irritates me, though, when you sign a deal... And, you know, you pick a producer and you go through those motions. The producer is always the first one to get paid and the last one to deliver what they need to deliver. So I think that drives me crazy. You know, it's the band usually is the last people to get paid. Everybody else gets paid before the band does, other than the manager. But, you know... That's how it kind of comes down to it. And when it takes a really long time, like in your case, you know, it's taken so long for, you know, a finished product. And I really feel unfairly you guys got gypped.
Well, in a sense, okay, as far as time, we got gypped. On the other hand, like, I don't mind giving, I don't know, I don't even know if I can really talk about some of it.
No worries.
But basically, like, as far as the label, like, I threw them a bone. I was like, yeah, you guys gave us money, at least some of the money, to record with my Clink. So that was, like, dream producer for some dirty rock and roll band of dudes that, like, we can barely afford enough money to go get coffee in the morning. So, yeah, that was fucking awesome. Thank you for that. But on the other hand, you guys kind of dropped the ball. So because they dropped the ball... We have a record that's finished, and we keep our masters. So I'm not mad about that.
That's
a plus.
So basically, if we go, I think, you know, our lawyer and Mike are talking to some labels. So just be like, okay, here's the product. It's already done. You just, like, you know, we're like a hot date. Like, we're ready to go. We're waiting on the corner. Like, call a cab, dude.
Yeah. No, call the Lyft or the Uber.
Lyft,
yeah,
Uber.
There's several cabs
in
this town.
I have a bone to pick with Uber, though, so, like, go with Lyft.
Really? What's your bone?
Okay. So, my guitar player, Maddie, his girlfriend calls an Uber for my girlfriend and my dog, Logan, and some of our stuff. Guy gets there. I'm like, hey, is it cool, you know, bring my dog? He's a service dog. And he's like, he didn't really speak to me. He didn't speak great English. But he's like, okay, cool. Fast forward the next morning, he charges Maddie's girlfriend $80 to clean out his car because apparently my dog shit and urinated and left hair all over his car. I'm like, my dog has never gone in the house. He's never chewed up anything. He just got groomed like a couple days before because he was shedding. So, and like I saw pictures. It was like, dude, you could have just taken a paper towel, wipe that off your seat. And there was definitely no urine or like feces in the car. So they still wouldn't refund her. So that's my bone with Uber. And I wrote them a long thing too. It was just like, look, I understand there is some dog hair, but that does not mean you had to go to professional service to like get it cleaned up. So use Lyft, people.
There it is.
There it is. And speaking of,
and use promo code Tortoise. And no, we need to get with Lyft. I'd be like,
no,
use promo
but you know, Melissa Simpson, who was here on our last show from Lose Your Fear, she is also a Lyft driver. As
I think
she was talking,
driver too. I think she does both.
Does she? Yeah. Well, a lot of them do. Dips. Yeah, they do. Dips. They have to.
Like putting your whole hand in the mouth.
Yeah, Dave Rita, he's a Lyft driver.
Yeah,
a lot of Lyft drivers out there.
I was a driver for a bit, but again,
he doesn't know how to drive. So
no, well, I was an Uber driver at the very beginning of Uber, and it wasn't what it is now, you know. And I've said this, you know, I wish drivers could, and I don't know if it. Hopefully, they changed it where there could be feedback to make the app a little bit more better, to make the driver's experience more better. Because I've had to deal with. I've had to deal with college kids, and that was fun, but same time, like, that's why I had a rule, no food in the car. Like, we can buy food, but no, you cannot eat in the car, because they just would go fucking apeshit crazy in the car.
I don't like when they don't play music. Like, when it's just you and it's just all awkward, it's like, just play something, play some shit dance music if you want. I don't care, but just
play your own
do
music.
Do something.
Yeah. You know what? I would always let people play their own music if they wanted to. Other than that, I would have it on the radio. You know, just.
I tell the drivers to play their own music, though. And I'm like, you're driving, dude. Like, I want you to be comfortable.
Yeah.
So just I get us relax. There in one piece, please. That's hard.
So what are you doing now? Are you just trying to do more gigs, or are you just recording?
I know. We're still kind of like trying to figure out what our next step is. I think three of the songs that I sent Max, one of which was Death Machine, Combat Boots, and Spun, we cut downtown with our friend Manny. He's his studio, and I think it's Lincoln Heights or Boyle Heights. So I'm just like, okay, we do have the Clink record, which is great, but even if we got signed tomorrow, you know, we're not going on a world tour. Mm-hmm. You know, there's going to be more red tape or whatever to go through.
Really?
So it was like the reason why we got signed, or the reason why we were playing the House of Blues and doing all that stuff and had traction before, was because we played everywhere. We put out music, even if it was kind of lo-fi, which, in my opinion, I really like the stuff we did with Manny, because I think it's a little more closer to how the band is live. You know, we just like did like, maybe there's only one rhythm guitar track and then Maddie's solo and then like put some overdrive on the bass. And then for the most part, there's not a whole lot of layering with my vocals, because that's just the kind of band we are, you know?
Well, you had fill-in drummers on the record too, right?
Oh, yeah, we had Kenny Arnoff did
great,
like
Kenny
90% of the record. Kenny is one awesome dude.
Yeah.
I'm like,
he hits like a beast.
He hits like a beast, and I'm like, dude, how, like, I couldn't keep up with Kenny. I'm like, he's nuts.
Let's hear another song. Let's do the Combat Boots one.
Combat Boots, if you just think Hendrix meets MC5.
Fantastic.
With a little punk swagger.
I love it. Okay.
It's a good description.
Yeah, let's play that song, and then I know you have to go. And, you know, do the whole
girlfriend
Valentine's Day thing. So we'll just keep you.
Even though it's
the
not
dog
really,
needs food.
And the dog needs food.
It's not really Valentine's Day, but.
Not really Valentine's Day. Which, by the way, I got the dog a treat for Valentine's Day. I was like, we're exploring downtown. And I saw this little dog food place. It was like duck jerky something. Like, it looked good enough that I'm like, I'm pretty sure humans could eat this, because it looks bomb. He just like looked at it and just like, no.
No.
He's a brat. But if another dog wants to eat it, then he's totally like, oh, this is, fuck, that's my
right?
treat.
That's my treat, bitch.
Yeah.
Everybody wants what they can't have.
Yeah.
Until they can have it, then they don't want it.
That's how it is
in life.
And
then somebody wants it and they're like, all right, I'll take it.
Yeah. And then he tries to hump something. So.
Typical human.
Does he still have his kibbles and bits?
Huh?
Does Logan still have his kibbles and bits.
He does. You know, he's weird though. He doesn't like toys. Like, he only likes food. Mm-hmm. Like, I got him toys. I'm like, he's like, I don't know what to do with this. I get a Subway sandwich. I'm like, turn the look the other way, and he's like, got half the sandwich down his mouth. Yeah. I'm like, thanks.
Cool. Let's hear Combat Boots. Then when we come back, last segment with Jack again. Thank you so much for coming in.
No, and, thank you, guys.
It's been a pleasure just seeing you. Because I follow you on the Facebook and the stuff like that. So
it's all a lie.
I'm sure it is.
I try to make it look fun.
It does.
What did, like, you say? Didn't you say you had a pattern for that? It's
Oh, yeah, because I'm not tech savvy at all. Like, I'm retarded. My girlfriend, like, gives me shit all the time about not being able to use apps. I'm just like, okay, so selfie, photo of the dog, I ate this shit today, I'm on my motorcycle, banned, and then, like, I don't know, something I think is kind of clever, but it's usually end up being cheesy. And then I just go in, like, that motion, because I feel like that works for me.
It keeps me entertained. I'm like, oh my God, Jack is having a great day.
I'm not always having, I just, you know what it is? I don't like when people get on social media, like, oh, fuck my life, blah, 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 this happened. I'm like, call your friends. That's what your friends are there for. To just bitch. Like, I call Max sometimes. I'm like, yeah, oh my God, I'm so angry. Like, my girlfriend was like, I really need you to be positive. Especially with the whole relapse. Like, I've gone almost a month clean and sober now. She's like, you really need to be positive. I'm like, all right, fine. I'll be positive. So I get on my bike. Right before the first exit, I'm like getting speed wobbles. And I thought, oh, did I, like, maybe I was like hydroplaning because it was raining that day. No, I pull over, flat tire. There's two nails in it. So I call her. I'm like, hey, remember that whole, like, be positive and all this stuff? I'm like, well, God has a sense of humor because I have a flat tire now. But it ended up working out. But, you know, it's, I'm trying. And that's all
but
I can do.
You didn't wreck, so that's
I didn't wreck. Although I almost got taken out by a Bentley the other day, and I was like, you know what? I wasn't going that fast. Maybe I could have just let her take me out. Like,
yeah, that would have been a paycheck.
If you want to go, though, I mean, getting hit by a Bentley, like, yeah, you got hit by a Bentley. Holy shit. Very cool. DTOfficial.com is... DTA. Did I say that? DTAofficial.com. That is where you could find the band...
There's also the Instagram if you guys want to go. I don't know who we. I don't even know if the site's still up, to be honest. I always think the site's up, but no one really checks it. The kids don't go on websites anymore.
No, let me check. I have your Instagram.
They don't. I don't even have one.
Well, your thing goes on the Instagram. I mean, I did your site.
Oh, yeah.
I'm on your site right now, and I pressed the Instagram.
See, that's how tech savvy I am. I don't even know what's on our website right now.
And I mean, I'm looking at your website. It's nice. Yeah, it goes straight to your website, which is a downtown attraction, all spelled. And yeah, I'm looking at it right now. There you are.
Oh. All right, you heard it first, folks. You're renewing your research, turtle.
It's working.
It's working.
It's working. Email ESMG. That means message.
Don't email them. I don't even think they get emails anymore.
No, really? I don't think they exist anymore.
But it'll be
anymore.
Like the name that. Should not be mentioned. Yeah. Okay.
If you don't mind, who does your website?
I think the man did the website.
The man?
Do you have, I think they did the website.
If you have keys to it, you can give it to me and I can take off some stuff if you want.
Okay.
I have no problem. Yeah, definitely helping you guys out. Thank you so much for coming on.
Thank you guys
really
for having
appreciate
me.
It. Earlier we heard Combat Boots. Let's hear one more song. Fine. Which song?
Spun.
Yeah, let's hear really Spun. Like Spun. Jack, dude.
You don't like it?
No, I love Spun. Spun, okay. I'll just say real quick. Basically, I was like, can we do like a Bowie meets The Clash, like something? Because most of downtown stuff, I'm always like running around yelling. I'm like, and as like when I was a guitar player, I was like, yeah, everything's got to be loud and fast, guitar solos. And then you start singing, you're like, you know what? Let's do a ballad. Let's take five, because like I can't breathe. I'm getting older. Like,
God.
So, but no, it's just kind of like a fun sort of Brit punk Bowie sort of track. So I think you guys will like it.
Very cool. DTAofficial.com is where you can find the band and link up with them on their Twitter, their Facebook, and of course their Instagram. Thank you so much, Jack, again for coming on. Really appreciate it. Just seeing you evolve and going through everything. I can't wait to see you again. So thank you so much. Max, any shout outs or anything that you want to do before we leave?
Oh, yeah. Okay. So
real quick, because this man has to go make love. But his wife or his wife.
Girlfriend.
His girlfriend can't. His girlfriend can't. You know?
She can wait a minute because we have sponsors.
I know. But you were there too. You were there too when you were dating whoever you were dating.
I never
did. You know, and those people. You wanted to spend time with them.
I want to spend time with no one.
But this is like the girls' day, though.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, yeah. Come on, Max. Yeah, yeah. Have a heart. Like, come on, real quick. Come on, Max.
All right, so Headgear and Hear Technologies, extreme honor to be involved with you. Zomitis Guitars and Dave Hager, thank you so much. I am so stoked. I can't wait to get my new guitar. David Russo, check out his stuff if you get a chance. Go online and check that out. Please support my bands. As you know, they are all out there and killing it, as always. Jack and Seven, Where Traitors Fall, Ivy Supler, Sean Barry, Michael Grant is still out with LA Guns and The Assassins. Tantric's about to go back out and do some more stuff. Mystery School is in the studio and killing it. And the Absence Project is also in the studio and doing things that are going to blow your mind. Check that stuff out. And go see my films, right?
Don't exactly.
You know?
The Winnebago. Go see Winnebago.
It's the Wendigo. Okay. The Wendigo Astro.
You did a horror movie in a trailer?
It's happening. Yeah. House of Manson is out on all sorts of things, on all of the streaming devices, so you can check that out. What are my other films that are out now?
I don't know. You have a ton, but this man has to go.
Attack of Bimbos, Shannon Rose's Misery, Missy, Smoke-Filled Lungs, a Doggone Mystery. I'm about to film that. Hell's Kitty.
I just realized I've been eating pizza this whole time.
You
I
have
forgot
been.
About the camera.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, totally.
It's like I couldn't chain smoke, so I had to do something.
Thank you to Jesse and Elizabeth and Danny and Chelsea and Michael and Melly and Ross and Diana and Ken and Mark Doty always.
And March 25th, that's a Saturday. Saturday, mm-hmm. March 25th, I'm going to be at an art and music tribute to the pop art movement. I'm going to be at the LA Pop Art Riot Saturday, March 25th, where I'll be interviewing these bands that are performing. I'll be interviewing Go Betty Go, Gina and the Eastern Block, and the band 222. So go out there and meet me. I know. You can actually meet me. And maybe if I have some free time, I can interview you for this really cool event. So come join me March 25th. For more information, log on to entertheshell.com. You'll see the banner. Click on that, and then you can get tickets. Otherwise, the price at the door is going to be a little bit more. Right. So make sure to go do that. Right. Once again, Downtown Attraction, Jack Cash, mwah, mwah, mwah. Kisses.
It's an affair. He's having an affair.
Thank you so much.
I got good cheekbones.
Yeah.
I think he's going to be very upset about this.
I mean, you got to be at the End of the Shell show, and now to this level, you know. So the scene has changed. I don't think I have. So,
it's nicer. It's really comfortable.
More comfortable.
Right? There's good.
I mean, there
services.
Actually are there craft services to complain about. Right? So it's like, you know, you guys are moving up.
Yeah. Thank you so much. True.